Available now on Blu-ray from Severin Films is Spanish director Eloy de Iglesia's 1970s horror thriller drama Cannibal Man. The title on the disc is Cannibal Man. The international English language market release was entitled Cannibal Man. Cannibal Man is a terrible, terrible title for this movie. It's absolutely misleading. There's no cannibalism in this movie. Maybe implied, not really any cannibalism in this movie. Little to no cannibalism in a film entitled Cannibal Man. It's just a salacious title that... the original Spanish title was something to the degree of The Week of the Killer, something like that. That makes way more sense than Cannibal Man does. This film is really, really good. There are two edits of the film on this Severin Blu-ray. You have the original English cut, and then you have the uncut Spanish version, which is a little bit longer. You can watch the film in English with Spanish subtitles or Spanish with English subtitles, Spanish or English dubbed, however you prefer, and either cut. This was really, really good. I had previously seen another film from Eloy de Iglesia. They had released, Severin, that is, has released a few of his titles together, and I'm just getting around to watching them one by one. No One Heard the Scream was the previous, which I really, really liked, and Cannibal Man, just about equally as good in my opinion. So basically, the very basic premise of this movie is that there's this guy lives alone, sort of in a slum with his brother, brother's away. This guy works in a factory, he's seeing this woman on the sly behind her boyfriend's back. They are out in a taxi one night. This titular non-cannibal man has an argument with a taxi driver, hits him in the head with a rock, and they leave. They leave him for whatever. Comes out in the newspaper that the guy died. Girlfriend has a problem with them not going to the police. Tiny spoiler. Our titular cannibal man winds up inadvertently killing the girlfriend. The rest of the movie is basically the bodies piling up. The rest of the movie is this now killer, people getting close to him, finding out that he has murdered somebody. He murders them, stashes the body. The key here is for people to not go to this guy's house, because basically people go to this guy's house, see the increasing number of bodies there, and he kills them to cover it up. And it's one of those, I would almost say it's noirish in that way, where something happens and it was an accident, and to cover things up. It reminds me of, in a way, A Simple Plan. Really, really good movie. I believe that was Sam Raimi. It was... Billy Bob Thornton and some guys, they find some cash, somebody let something slip, and it's just one thing after another trying to undo the bad thing that was done. That's what Cannibal Man is about. It's not really about cannibalism. In a very, very tiny way it might be, but it's really not about cannibalism. I must warn folks, there is the titular non-cannibal man works in a slaughterhouse, and at least in the full-length version of the film, the Spanish cut, there is actual slaughterhouse footage. It ain't pleasant. I mean, many of us meat eaters are told we should probably be aware of where our food comes from, but many of us also don't want to see it. We just want to eat it. So there is that in there. Otherwise, it's a really, really well-done drama. The performances are solid. The direction is solid. It looks really good in this transfer. There are some extras. Like I said, you get the two versions of the movie. You get a featurette about censorship in Spain at the time this film was made, and another piece about the director, which they interview the biographer of the director across all of these Severin de Iglesia discs. And it's interesting. It's a director I didn't know, and there are films I didn't know. I think I might have heard of Cannibal Man. It had, I think, a UK and a US release under that title. But this movie is really good. It's not as, despite the title and despite the slaughterhouse footage, it's not as extreme as one might think from the title. It really is more of this slow turning of the screws on this guy who acted impulsively and repeatedly keeps lapsing into the most inappropriate behavior possible to avoid detection and avoid his eventual, you know, capture. Whether or not he gets captured, who knows? You have to watch the movie. But it's really, really good. at any rate, a film I quite enjoyed. It was the same star, actually, the same lead male performer as No One Heard the Scream in this. This one, I think, came first. And really well done. There are outtakes from the film. There's about two minutes of very eye-opening outtakes, which, had they been left in the film, would have substantially changed the relationship between a couple of the characters. Usually outtakes are these, you know, unimportant, very brief things that, or deleted scenes. They don't really add, they just would have slowed the movie down. This would have kind of changed the movie in many ways. So those are very interesting to see. Anyway, Cannibal Man, he's really not a cannibal. Kind of, but not really. Cannibal Man on Blu-ray now from Severin Films. I quite highly recommend it if you're a fan of foreign horror.